This is the SAP Developer News for March 14, 2024.
You may already know that this summer, first week in June, marks the SAP Developer Mega Event, Code Connect, where we start on the Monday, the 3rd of June, with a Code Jam on CAP, followed by three consecutive one-day conferences, Recap on Tuesday, UI5Con on Wednesday, and ABAP Conf 2024 Europe on Thursday. So, Code Connect week is the first week in June, but registration for the one-day conferences opens next week on the 21st of March, 4 p.m. CET precisely. So get ready to register and see you there.
Did you know the BTP CLI can give you a rich directory and subaccount hierarchy? Requesting basic information about your global account gives you some simple details like this. But if you add the show hierarchy parameter, you get a lovely graphical representation of the directories and subaccounts like this. Not only that, but you can get this same information in a machine parsable format, JSON. What's not to like?
Hey there, I will be in Las Vegas next week at the SAP Insider event at the Bellagio. And so should you, because we are hosting the Code Challenge session on Monday, where we will show you SAP's AI portfolio, and we also prepared a system for you to try out our AI portfolio, and especially Generative AI Hub on SAP AI Core. And the winning team can even win a little surprise prize. So make sure you stop by and try out the AI portfolio with us. Learn a lot about it, and we will code together. There's going to be pizza, I heard, I think. So yeah, make sure to stop by and take part in the code challenge and maybe even win a prize. See you there.
Hey everyone. For those of you working in CDS, have you wondered if the access control settings of a released SAP CDS view could be reused? Well, it is possible in ABAP Cloud. Our friend Andrew Fisher explains in this blog post with an example of the DCL source code. The role defines the access control which is inherited from the base CDS entity, for example, iBusinessUserBasic. Usage of this will throw an error as it requires a special syntax. You need to have custom code entity with 1:1 association to the base entity. Additionally, use this syntax in the DCL which will ensure that inheritance will still work even if SAP would add additional authorization checks. In this way, the access control to base CDS views can be inherited by other CDS views. The link to the blog post is in the description below.
Hola, SAP developers. In case you missed it, there's a new Terraform provider in town. That's the SAP BTP provider. You can find it in the Terraform registry. Release 1.0 was announced in early February, and as promised, there is a monthly release cadence for it, meaning that version 1.1 was published a few days ago. In the latest version, we can now update our directories and enable features and entitlements for them. Also, a new data source was added, which can allow us to view the hierarchy of a global account. Check it out. Now, over to SAP Integration Suite. Gabriela recently published a blog post covering what's new for SAP Integration Suite in February, and I just want to highlight a few items included there. Related to cloud integration, you can now inspect your resource consumption through SAP Cloud ALM. And there is a call to action to upgrade to a new version of a few third-party connectors. Now, in Advanced Event Mesh, there is a couple of things that many of you have been waiting for. We can now send events from SAP S/4HANA Cloud to Advanced Event Mesh. Also, distributed tracing can now be enabled in Advanced Event Mesh. I just want to remind you that if you want to keep up to date with what's new in SAP Integration Suite, make sure to keep an eye on the page available in help.sap.com.
Hey everybody, Josh Bentley. And as you know, I love to keep you informed on lots of things that are happening in the open source space, but I also love it when we take some of these great updates from the Kyma open source community and we put them into the SAP BTP Kyma runtime and they become officially supported updates. There are two updates that I wanted to make you aware of today. The first is support in the Kyma runtime for smaller machine types. The smaller machine types are two virtual CPUs with 8 gigabits of RAM. They're available to help you optimize the size of your default Kyma runtime installation and thus reduce cost. The second update is the SAP BTP Kyma runtime has the SAP BTP operator as a default module. Now, the operator has been upgraded to a default Kyma module, and it's now automatically added to all new clusters. This enhancement ensures that service management is readily available. For more information on this, read the linked Kyma modules document as well as the linked updates to both help documentation files.